Hey guys, welcome back to another today's video. And this new today's video is going to be a brand new video, part of my video series of breaking up the two-party duopoly. And this new video series, this is going to be talking about another alternative candidate that's actually running for U.S. Senate in 2022. And his name is Matthew Ho, and he's running as a nominee of the Green Party. And he's running for U.S. Senate in North Carolina in 2022. To succeed current incumbent Republican Senator Richard Burr from the state of North Carolina. But before I begin with this and talking about him as a candidate and where he stands on a lot of issues and why he's ultimately running for U.S. Senate, aren't you tired of American politics? Are you tired of the political dysfunction all across this nation, are you tired, especially Californians? I'm talking to you, Californians, for one. Are you tired of the dysfunction? Are you tired of the corrupt two-party system that has proven time and time again that they refuse to work together, the focus on the issues that each and every one of us cares about as Americans, like climate change, fixing our broken healthcare system, pursuing reforms to making our immigration system much more better, climate change for one, focusing on inflation, the supply chain crisis, like on a lot of those economic issues that we are facing currently. Aren't you tired of it? Aren't you tired of the current political dysfunction? Aren't you tired of all that? Well, you know I am, and why I joined the California RCV Coalition, and what the California RCV Coalition is, and why they have formed, simply because they are working towards pursuing ranked choice voting, to implement ranked choice voting all across the state of California. That's why they started this movement. Why they started this movement for one, starting on March 1st at 7 p.m. Pacific Standard Time, we'll be holding our first fundraiser called California RCV Fundraiser, Making Our Voices Heard. This is going to help us raise money for our historic movement all across the state of California to one day pursue a ballot initiative that will implement ranked choice voting for all state elections, statewide elections, for all federal elections, and also for local elections even. And if you don't know what ranked choice voting is, what ranked choice voting is that it is an alternative voting method where instead of just voting for one candidate, you get to rank the candidates honestly. It gives you the freedom to vote for your favorite candidate as your number one pick, but you also get a series of backup choices from your second to third choice. Those would be your technically your backup choices to ensure that your vote is not wasted anymore. And that's what ranked choice voting is. You rank your favorite candidate as number one, your second choice candidate as number two, your third choice candidate as number three, your fourth choice candidate as number four, and your fifth choice candidate as number five, and your least favorite choice, the person that you dislike the most, will always appear at the bottom of your ranking. You're pretty much voting your conscience now. You're free to vote your conscience, and your vote is no longer wasted anymore. Fewer votes are wasted. And that's what ranked choice voting is. It's there to give you more choice and more voice, in which third parties and independent candidates, they no longer have to run being spoilers anymore. They don't have to run with the nickname of splitting the vote anymore. And that's a good thing, because now those candidates can actually run and actually be evaluated upon by the voters. And if they're taking votes away from the Republicans or Democrats, well, the Republicans and Democrats, their response is they're going to have to be more friendlier to their opponents' voters. They're going to have to try to form consensus and reach out and engage in positive campaigning with their opponent supporters, to making sure that their opponent supporters are ranking them second to ensure that they have that majority, where they have to stand for something, stick to the issues, stay positive, to ensure that they will be the one with the majority of the vote at the end of the day, which ultimately guarantees them election or re-election. And that's what ranked choice voting is. And if you're tired, and if you're really interested in engaged in joining the California RCV Coalition, helping us pursue a ballot and statewide initiative to actually implement ranked choice voting all across the state of California for all of California's elections, federal, state, and local, then join them. RSVP now to attend the March 1st fundraiser to help us raise money, for our historic and diverse, for our nonpartisan movement to advance ranked choice voting all across this incredible Golden State. And yes, you're going to get to meet great people. We're going to have a special guest join us. It is Representative Barbara Lee, representing a current representative of the United States Congress. She's representing California's 13th congressional district, and this is one of our special guests. So if you're interested, if you have some free time on March 1st at 7 p.m. Pacific Standard Time, RSVP right now, and I will be there as well. You get to meet a lot of great people like myself to be a part of this historic and diverse movement to pursue ranked choice voting all across the Golden State for generations to come. So if you're excited and interested in joining this incredible movement, then join us. And so now, going back to the main topic of this video, talking about Matthew Ho for U.S. Senate in 2022, the biggest reason why he's running for U.S. Senate is to build a grassroots political independence from this two-party system built around money. And that's the biggest reason why he's running, because someone like myself, who is also tired of this political system, even though we're from separate states, but we have a common interest, we want to move away from the two-party system. We want to build a new political foundation, a new political movement, to reimagine a new and bold future for America, for California, and for North Carolina for generations to come. And that's the biggest reason why he's running for U.S. Senate. And going even further and talking about him as his campaign for U.S. Senate, let's talk about him as a person, about Nat. For much of my life, North Carolina has been my home. It is a place that has welcomed and supported me, where my family lives, and a place where I was able to rebuild my life after the wars. I spent 10 years in the Marine Corps and went to war 3 times before realizing the courage to stand against those unjust, immoral, and counterproductive wars. Since 2009, I have not only fought against the war machine, but also against the systemic, political, and financial rot that underlies and connects our problems in North Carolina, the United States, and beyond. It's not just the overseas wars that have stolen futures from our country and others. It's also the wars against the working class, the continued racial injustices, the war on drugs, the crime-for-profit healthcare system, and our unsustainable housing crisis, and so many other inequalities, injustices, and inequities that not only stifle individuals and families, but diminish and hold back entire neighborhoods, communities, municipalities, and our entire country. I love my country. More to the point, I love the people of my country. I see them suffering. 62% of Americans want a third party in power because they know how much the current political and financial systems holds us back, and how better we can be. Please join me in this campaign to break our political system away from the corrupt two-party system beholden to the wealthy, the banks, and the corporations. I would not be running if this were not necessary. And if I did not think it is possible to retake, reimagine, and rebuild our political system. And once again, that's why he's running, to build a political independence movement away from the two-party system that's only prioritized and beholden only to the wealthy, that's only beholden to the banks and the corporations. He wants to break this corrupt political system, to reimagine it into a government that's truly by, of, and for the people. He gets their pains. He's been in the Marine Corps. He's seen firsthand. He knows the cost of war firsthand that puts many Americans through. He knows that. And that's what he wants. And that's, he cares about the people. He loves the people of his country. And he sees them suffering and he wants to address them. He wants to address their struggles, to help lift them out of their desperate issues and problems in life, and help give them the tool sets to live their dreams, where they can have the freedom to choose a life that they want, that they have always dreamed of living. And that's what he will do. He knows that the people want change. He knows 62% of Americans want change. Those Americans he sees are the people that just want the problems that we are facing in the 21st century to be fixed. Like making the, such as reforming our healthcare system to pursue a much more affordable path, to pursue policies that will make housing much more affordable in all regions of the country, to address inequalities, injustices, and inequities. He wants to end the war on drugs and focus on ending racial injustices all across the country. And that's why he's running for U.S. Senate in North Carolina, the biggest part of that. And that is to truly reimagine our political system, where it's much more responsive to the times that we're living in. And that's why he's running. So now that you know a little bit about him as a person, and why he's ultimately running for U.S. Senate in 2022 to be the next senator from the state of North Carolina, let's talk about where he stands on some of the issues. Let's start on ending political corruption and building a democracy for all. We'll get to some of them. We won't get to all of them because I want to only get to a handful of them. And I'll let you guys look it over. If you do live in North Carolina, I will leave his campaign website in the description below, so you guys can get to actually check him out even further. And actually, maybe, and you never know, you might want to volunteer and join his campaign for U.S. Senate. So let's talk about on one thing: ending the political corruption and building a democracy for all. Because we all know that he's all for establishing a political independence away from the two-party system, to truly reimagine our political structure from the ground up, in which he's focusing on building a truly democratic government that's only beholden to not corporations, to not the super wealthy, but to the people of this great nation. And how he will do this is that he wants to get money out of politics. He's going to pursue policies like a public financing system with a limited campaign window. He wants to end gerrymandering. He wants to implement things like ranked choice voting. He wants to enact proportional representation. He wants term limits for members of Congress. He wants to provide for fair ballot access and regulations. He wants full ex-felon voting enfranchisements. He wants stricter financial controls for members of Congress and their staff. And this includes no Wall Street transactions and disinvestment from any stock, funds, or industries related to the oversights and appropriation committees on which members of Congress serve. He wants to bring our government back where they're only responsive to the people and caring about what the people are going through, and helping and pursuing policies that each and every one of us all cares about, that you North Carolinians care about. And that's the biggest reason why he's running for U.S. Senate in North Carolina, to truly build a political independence that will reimagine our political system for the better. And going even further on, he supports a comprehensive, locally focused, nationalized healthcare system, something that's similar in healthcare, similar to in Canada, I mean. He doesn't believe that profit has no place in healthcare. He believes healthcare is a basic human right with no compromises will be acceptable. He wants a single payer healthcare system similar to what Canada wants, and that's one of the and he supports that because he believes that healthcare is a human right and he wants to help make healthcare affordable for every single American. That's why he supports a single payer style of system, and also he wants to end the war on drugs. He thinks it was very costly, and that has led to the over imprisonment of America's U.S. prisons, because we have. One of the things I've learned is that the United States is one of the largest, has one of the largest prison populations in the world. And that's mainly due to our past policies on the war on drugs. It has imprisoned so many people and are behind bars. And that has destroyed so many individuals and families and communities throughout the U.S. And he doesn't think that doesn't make any sense anymore. So part of like pursuing criminal justice reform is by ending the war. The war on drugs is a priority. He's going to legalize all forms of narcotics to end the prohibition that drives crimes. He wants to put an end to corporate prisons and treat addiction and substance abuse as a public health crisis. And also, he believes in guaranteed sick and family leave pay. He supports a livable wage. He also supports things that will help pursue public banking and debt forgiveness, simply because, and as I quote him here, debt forgiveness, medical and education in particular, along with the opportunities public banking can provide, will be a massive investment and spark for our economy and nation. We need to commit to housing as a right, understand houses as homes and not investment, and enshrine the Renters Bill of Rights. I am aware of the difficulties small businesses are under. I am outraged at how large corporations have profited from the pandemic and received the lion's share of government bailouts, while government policies harmed small businesses. Too much of the cost with so little reward is carried by the individual worker and small businesses. We must make corporations and banks pay their fair share and provide emergency relief aimed at small businesses affected by the pandemic. Employee ownership and unionization must be incentivized and must be clear and well-resourced goal for our federal policies. If we can make sure every American has healthcare, the freedom to pursue higher education at no cost, and the chance to have ownership of their labor, we can make this nation into an economic powerhouse through the next century. And that's where he stands on like economic democracy. He wants to provide every single American the chance to live their lives the way they see fit, to pursue a dream that they've always envisioned since they were a kid. And that's why he's running, because he cares about these issues. He cares about it. And the first thing he's gonna do to deliver these changes is to build a government that's much more responsive to the needs of our time. Things like ranked choice voting, proportional representation, ending gerrymandering, getting money out of politics, fair ballot access and regulation, full ex-fill and voting enfranchisement. Things like those things to pursue real electoral reform is what will truly reimagine a political system that Matthew Ho has envisioned in his mind. And that's why he's running for U.S. Senate in North Carolina. And if you live in North Carolina, if you want to support him, if you want to vote for him, if you want this alternative candidate to be on the ballot in 2022, then sign the Green Party's petition. They need actually about, we need volunteers committed to collecting 14,000 signatures. The Green Party needs about 14,000 signatures by May 1st, 2022 to actually get access to the ballot this November. So if you want to get, if you believe in Matthew Hill's campaign, if you believe in it, believing in him, if you want to reimagine and help him build a grassroots political independence from the away from this two-party system and to reimagine a government that's truly by, of, and for the people, then sign this petition, volunteer for his campaign, volunteer for the Green Party, and help them collect 14,000 petition signatures in North Carolina and get it done by May 1st, 2022, to give more of your fellow North Carolinians a real choice and a real voice that will truly put people first over politics for generations to come. So once again, you guys, well, what do you really think about him as a Senate candidate? If you live in North Carolina, would it be someone that you would consider voting for? Do you agree with him on some issues? Well, you know, on some issues, I may not agree with them on getting rid of the Electoral College, on getting rid of the filibuster, but I do have some common ground with him on ranked choice voting. And on proportional representation, I have some common ground with them on those proposals. And simply because I think that will help build a much more inclusive and competitive democracy. And that's why I'm endorsing him on this channel and why he has my support from the Reimagine America movement, designed to break up the two-party system, fix American democracy, where we're truly reimagining a government that is much more responsive to the people's needs of the 21st century. And that's why he has my support in 2022 to be the next senator from the state of North Carolina. So once again, guys, thank you so much for watching this video. And comment down below, what do you think about Matthew Hill's campaign? And if you're a fellow Californian like I am, will you RSVP for the March 1st fundraiser to help us raise money to one day pursue, to help us pursue a statewide ballot initiative to implement ranked choice voting all across the state of California. But once again, guys, thank you so much for watching this video. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and comment down below. And until next time, this is Young Centrist, and I am out.
Hi, I'm Matthew Ho, and today I'm announcing my campaign to represent North Carolina in the United States Senate. This past summer, the fiasco of 20 years of counterproductive, horrific, and futile war was made clear to us as U.S. forces retreated from Afghanistan. Here, in the U.S., we measure our government's failure to protect and care for us through the more than 750,000 dead from COVID. We keep witnessing, undeniably, the brutal reality of a changing world and a threatened future, from a worsening economic situation for the majority of us, and from the climate crisis for all of us. This is made possible by a two-party political arrangement beholden to corporate interests and a lawmaking system of legalized bribery. This is a majestic and grand farce that is costing us individually and together so very much. This is why I am running, because the answer lies in political independence from this two-party system built on money. Together, let us retake and rebuild our government into a government for us, one that will end the wars overseas, as well as the wars at home, ensure economic equality and economic freedom, guarantee health care and education, defend our liberties, and protect our planet. Please join me in this campaign for U.S. Senate. This will be a campaign built on democratic principles, moral values, constitutional ideals, economic reality, and not just guarding our future, but making it into something we know it can be. Thank you.